Now, ever since we've been talking about the loot goblin and the hoarder, I have been getting comment after comment about the chill out mask and about making a new DPS build to not only take on the hoarder, but to also showcase the chill out mask. So, well, you know, I felt what better way to showcase the chill out mask, but with a DPS build with 200% crit hit damage, max crit chance, and 35% amplified damage, 40% amplified damage on my secondary weapon. You want to know how? Here we go. What's going on, YouTube? Kamikaze Von Doom here with another Division 2 build video. Now, shout out to the DoD Disciples of Doom. And in today's build video, I'm going to showcase to you a chill-out DPS build that you can use in PvP or PvE. It does not matter. I'll show you all of the gameplay at the end. I'll be doing Heroic with 4 directives solo, and I'll be knocking out some skulls in some PvP. So I hope you enjoy. All of the timestamps and everything will be added after the live premiere. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into the build breakdown. Here we go. Now, right off the bat, the funny part about this build is that it is a DPS build through and through. It's an all-red DPS build. The only blue is because of the Picaros, but it comes with a weapon damage core. So technically, we're running 6 weapon damage cores on, you know, one on each of our items, and we get an additional armor core. So the cool thing about this build is that you get all of this damage, but because of the brand set bonuses, instead of the normal, you know, 900k armor or something that you would typically have with an all red build, now you bump that sucker up to 1.1 million, and we are still sitting at max crit chance and 200% crit hit damage. Not only that, but we get amplified damage from our weapon, and we get amplified damage from our chest piece. Now, if you're worried about survivability, you can easily just add a few blue cores on here and you'd be good to go. But I'm showing you that you don't even need that. You can just use it the way it is right here, and it's smooth sailing. So with that being said, let's start off at the top with the specialization, because some of these do matter with this build setup. I would typically go with like an Ouroboros, you know, shield splinter, maybe go like, glass cannon or something, typically. But I felt that without the incoming damage and you're a little more tanky because of these brand set bonuses, why not go with, you know, spotter flatline, amplify that damage, you know, pretty much the same amount, and still be able to rely on that tankiness for that survivability. And then if that's not enough, you get the bonus armor every time you are around an enemy from the adrenaline rush. Now, starting off at the top, we have the specialization, the Technician. Now, the Technician specialization is vital for this build because it gives us the linked laser pointer. Now, we are using the linked laser pointer on both of our weapons. It is only available on the long underbarrel rail attachment slot. And lucky for us, both of our weapons, being the Vector 45 ACP and the Kingbreaker, both hold that attachment slot. So therefore, we can put the linked laser pointer on there, and bada bing, bada boom, they get pulsed. Now, the reason why we want to pulse our enemies is because on our primary weapon, we have the talent flatline, which amplifies our weapon damage to pulsed enemies. And our secondary weapon is perfect flatline, and that one amplifies our weapon damage by 20%. Now, not only that, but wait, there's more. If you go to the chest piece, we have Perfect Spada. Now, Perfect Spada gives us 20% additional amplified damage. Now, don't get it mixed up. These don't cancel each other out. Once you activate this, both of them are activated. So the linked laser pointer from the technician with the flatline, perfect flatline, and then the perfect spotter, all of these perfectly like synergize together. So it is a, I don't know, like a gimme that you put these together, because you know that if you have flatline or perfect flatline, you might as well use perfect spotter or spotter because they activate together. And if you're going to do that, you might as well run the technician. That way you can use the linked laser pointer, because the linked laser pointer, how it works is all you have to do is aim your weapon at the enemy and it will then pulse the enemy. The only instance will where it doesn't is if they're wearing like, say, Y'all gear or say System Corruption, where they have a lot of pulse resistance. But 9 times out of 10, they're just going to get pulsed immediately. And then, you know, boom, you get that amplified damage and it's lights out. I mean, they're getting melted. Now, as far as the weapon stats, we'll start with the Vector. So the Vector is sitting at 107.5K total damage, and that's at Expertise 26, with damage to targets at a cover. Now, everything is maxed out, and we do have Flatline on there to amplify our damage. Going to the Kingbreaker, we're sitting at 150 total damage, and that is with also damage to targets at a cover and perfect flatline, amplifying our damage to 20%, but with the chest piece, that's where it becomes 40. So we get 35% amplified with the Vector, and we get 40% amplified with the Kingbreaker. And yes, I am using the card custom for a reason. So the card custom will give us an additional skill tier. Now, in PvP, what I will do is I'll switch the scanner pulse to a jammer. And in PvP, if I have the card custom out, I'll get a tier 2 jammer. Now, remember, in PvP, your jammer pulse will only jam skills that are equal to or plus 3 of your skill tier. So that means I can only jam up to a tier 5 skill build with this setup. Now, if I do not have the pistol in my hand when I jam, I can only jam up to a tier 4 skill build. So that's why I have the TDI card custom. So all of this is actually a must-have for my build setup, just so you know. As far as the build gear items, these are pretty much required. The only thing that is not required is all of the reds. You can switch them to blue core attributes if you want. You could go full tank if you want. It doesn't matter. I wanted to show you a DPS build with this crazy high crit, and that's exactly what I gave you. If you want to make it a tank build, by all means, it's pretty much easier to do it that way, because the chill out mask and the closer, they both come with a blue core anyways. So me making them a red core just made it more difficult for you as it is. So if you want to go more tanky, by all means, go for it. But you really don't have to. And this is the equivalent of running an all red build, but now you have 1.1 million armor and no extra incoming damage from something like glass cannon or perfect glass cannon. Not only that, but then you also get the adrenaline rush. So if you're like me and you like to run and gun, this is going to be the build for you. Now, if it is too squishy for you, by all means, add a few blue core attributes and you'll be good to go. I promise. This build schmacks. All right. Now, to start with the build, we need to start with the star of the show, the chill out mask. The only reason why I'm putting this build together is because of the chill out mask and because it is available right now. Remember, you can only get this mask for the next 4 days from the Hoarder, from the Loot Goblin. You only have 4 more days to get this mask. Now, for this build, I have crit hit damage rolled on the bottom attribute. I changed the core attribute to a weapon damage core, and then I added 2 crit hit damage mods. So just from this one item, I get 5% total armor, 36% crit hit damage, and I get weapon damage from the core. Going to the chess piece, this is the closer. This is the named Usina Getica chess piece with Perfect Spotter as a talent. Now, this one also gives you total armor from the brand set bonus. So with our build combination, we get plus 10% total armor on top of everything else. And it's an all red build. It's crazy. Now, as far as the attributes, weapon damage for the core, double crit, and a crit damage mod. And again, Perfect Spotter, amplifying weapon and skill damage by 20% to all pulsed enemies. Let's go to the backpack. This is the Grupo Sombra backpack. Now, the Grupo brand set bonus for this build gives us 15% crit hit damage. We have double crit on here with a crit damage mod and Adrenaline Rush. Now, Adrenaline Rush is different for PvP and PvE. Now, for PvE, it is 20% per stack. However, for PvP, it is cut in half to only 10% per stack. And that is bonus armor, just so you know. Now, going down to the gloves and knee pads, both Sokolov Concern. Now, the reason for that is our main weapon is the Vector 45 ACP, and Sokolov Concern not only gives us SMG damage from the brand set bonus, but it also gives us crit hit damage from the brand set bonus. As far as the attributes, we have weapon damage for the core and double crit. Going down to the knee pads, our other piece of Sokolov Concern, again, weapon damage for the core and double crit. And that leaves us, dear agents, with our last item of the build breakdown, the Picaro's holster. Now, this is the named Brazos holster with weapon damage as a normal attribute. However, you also get armor, skill haste from the brand set bonus, and we have crit hit damage rolled on there as well. And that is the build. Not bad, right? Max crit chance, 200% crit hit damage. You have 1.1 million armor. You have amplified damage. You have bonus armor. What more could you ask for? I mean, come on. You whip out the pistol. You get two skill tiers from that and the technician. You're good to go. Now let's finish up with the stats, and then we'll jump over to the gameplay. Now this is for the Vector. We're sitting at 107.5k weapon damage. 35.8k for PvP. We're at max crit chance, 200% crit hit damage, and 70 headshot. Don't forget about the damage to targets at a cover. Going down to the offensive tab, we're sitting at 126% all weapons damage bonus and 40% SMG damage bonus. So every time we are using the Vector, we are starting off at 166% damage bonus total. That's before the amplified. That's before the crit. Oh, this thing is a lot of fun. You got to try it. Adrenaline Rush just to help your survivability. Perfect Spotter to go with the flatline and perfect flatline. Going down to the defensive tab, we are just under 1.1 million armor. We're sitting at 363k health, and we do have 10% explosive and hazard protection, but that's due to my watch level. So here is my disclaimer for all my build videos. I am sitting at watch level 9,351. That means all these boxes are maxed out 50 of 50. Now, if you are at or above Shade Level 1000, you can copy and paste my build and get the exact same numbers and results. However, if you are below Shade Level 1000, some of these boxes are not going to be maxed out. Therefore, where you go to copy and paste my build, some of your numbers might not add up. It's okay. Don't freak out. It's still a great build to use, I promise you. Just remember that whenever you reach Shade Level 1000, all of these attribute boxes will be maxed out, and then you can copy and paste my build and get the same numbers. And then you can start worrying about the expertise part of things. But that is it for the build breakdown. I hope you enjoyed. Now, if you haven't already, hit that thumbs up, support the channel by subscribing, and let's jump over to some PvE and PvP gameplay. Take care of yourself. I am Kamikaze Von Doom. Peace out. Oh, yeah. And roll that footage. Oh, push. Push. Get them out of our spawn, man. Get these people out of our spawn. Why did it put me into this game? There we go. GG's. All right. There you go. Push up. Push up. Uh-oh. They have damage. Yo, they have damage. We gotta watch out. Oh, one guy right here is on a medi. Oh, he's running. Oh. Got him. There's one. Hold on. They're still on damage. Just wait. Oh, they're alleyway. They're alleyway. Oh, there's two. Behind, behind. There's three. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Let's go. Let's go. And here we are for some PvP gameplay. This is going to be conflict PvP. First off, it's going to be 4v4 PvP. The game mode is going to be skirmish, which is first teamed 20 kills wins. And the map is going to be Capital Ruins. Now, shout out to my team and shout out to the other team. I'll pull up the roster here in a second and show you everyone's name. But what I am doing for this gameplay is I just solo queued into PvP, conflict PvP. You can do this right underneath the helicopter pad at the base of ops. And it puts you into a random PvP team against another random PvP team. If you're solo, it will typically try to match you up with other solo people. But if not, it'll just throw you into a random group, you know. And here we go. Now this is going to be with the Vector Kingbreaker combo. Flatline, perfect flatline, featuring perfect spotter as well. We have max crit chance and 200% crit hit damage. And that is before all of the amplified damage. Here we go. Now, if you haven't already, hit that thumbs up. Support the channel by subscribing. And let me know what you think in the comment section below. And finally, shout out where you're from. It's always cool to see where everyone's from. But here we go. Now, what I typically like to do is I start off with the Kingbreaker in PvP. And then I'll switch down to the Vector. That way, I can get some big amounts of damage off as a surprise. And then whenever it's down to the actual, like, 1v1, we'll switch to the Vector.
Hostile assault turret detected. Hostile explosive Sigma mine detected. Hostile defender drone.
Oh, he just detected. I thought he was following me. Oh, that other guy's beaming. Watch out for that other guy. Standby. Chaos unfolding. They're all dead. They're all dead. Yep, pulse them. I'm just trying to pulse all of them right now. Right there on the car. All right, I'm gonna risk it for the biscuit. All right, risking it for the biscuit.
Boost about to activate.
He's almost down. Nice. Good job. Woo. Got him. And the boost. Going for the boost. Oop, spawn's flipped. Uh-oh, this is really bad for the boost. Aw, crap. This is very bad for the boost. I'm gonna need your help at the boost. Oh man, this is gonna suck. Let's see if I can do it this way. Oh, come on. I know you're gonna go for it. It's the bait.
Boost about to expire.
I'm trapping a rabbit. Oh, dude, they didn't go for it? What?
The boost is being taken by allies.
Yo, they never went for it?
Hostile stinger hive
what?
Detected.
Wow.
The boost has been taken by allies.
It was on their side, too. They're
hostile
still in their map. They're still in
detected.
Their spawn. Oh, my gosh. Yo, they're in the garage. Stand by. Nope, they're not in the garage. They're just in their spawn. Oh, this game's over, man. Yeah.
Agent down.
I'm not going in there and losing my armor. At least let them come out. Come on out. Come on. I ain't gonna hurt you. I ain't gonna hurt you much.
I'm sending you a specialization supply.
Yo, come on. Get out your spawn. Come on with it. Alright, where's the helicopter? Oh, I see it. Death by snoo snoo. I mean, what?
An agent needs assistance.
All right, we have 10 seconds to get one kill.
The specialization supply.
All right, we have 5 seconds to get one kill. Oh, there's Mercy. GG's. GG's.
You've won an emphatic victory.
Emphatic victory. Emphatic. Emphatic victory. Hey, MVP, let's go. Hey, shout out to my team. Let's get it. We had a good group. Strong. Strong PvP agents. All right, MVP, 1 million XP. I went 3-0-1, 12 million damage. Let's go. All right. That game went a little too quick, so let's try this again. All right, so PvP gameplay for our perfect spotter chill out combination. All right, here we go. Oh, looks like my teammates are on the other team this time. And we are jumping over to Stadium is going to be the map. All right. If you haven't already, hit the thumbs up. Support the channel. Let's get it. Thank you. Yo, that one guy looked like he was straight out of like a World War World War One or World War Two movie. He's got the little cadet outfit or whatever. I totally forgot about that outfit. This guy right here. That's awesome. Hey, man. Kudos on the outfit. How is he able to, like, strafe like that and still run faster than me? I don't get it. What am I doing wrong? I can't even run that fast in a straight line. This guy's, like, zigzagging faster. Is it just me? What am I doing? Scuba Steve. Yo, is that an assault turret? Aw, dude, this is not good. This guy's using a freaking assault turret. You never use an assault turret for a freaking PvP, bruh. Never. Never. You do not use assault turrets for PvP. Oh, and they have mortars? Oh, dude, this is no bueno. Oh, they have mortars, my guy. Back up, dude. Back. Oh, my gosh. All right, we might... Oh, man. This is bad. We have a guy on our team. Yo, shoot him. He's right here. Thank you. I'm looking for him. They're going far left. Jeff, watch out. Watch out, Jeff. Jeff. Oh, they're all running at you, bro. Watch out. Oh, my gosh. They're all going after you, man. No, back up, Jeff. Back up, Jeff. No, Jeff. No, Jeff. Damn it, Bobby. Ooh.
Boost now active.
He's candy. Up top. Our side. Yep, pick it up, pick it up. Allies underneath us. The boost.
Allies have acquired the boost.
Oh, they're pushing up.
Hostile hive detected.
Watch out.
Hostile defender drone detected.
Oh,
got me. Critical.
No.
Agent down. Agent killed. Hostile explosive.
I thought he was down by the way he was pulsed, but he wasn't down. He was just sitting in cover. So I rushed up on him. I was like, oh, he's down? No, he wasn't down. Just messing with you, man. All right. Serious face on.
Agent needs assistance.
Scuba Steve's in trouble. Oh, no. My whole team's in trouble. He's right there, Steve. Oh, my gosh. He was trying to make me run down the alley.
Agent down. Hostile artillery turret detected. System back online.
Oh, man, the mortars. I forgot about the mortars. Go up top, go up top. Go up top.
A specialization supply drop has been arranged for you. Friendly claiming the supply drop.
Not today, Satan.
The specialization supply drop has been claimed by
Oh, unbreakable. Unbreakable. I'm not a big fan of Unbreakable, but I see why people use it. Because they do win those engagements right there. Because it's like, oh, I got him. And then as soon as I see that Unbreakable proc, I'm like, damn it. Oh, what just happened? Oh. Oh. What was that? CIA just hacked my ish? What was that, man? What the hell? What the hell? Oh my god. Whoa. Oh. Oh. We're up by two. Just got out of that sticky situation like a champ.
Hostile hive detected.
I will admit. I sure did.
Agent down.
There are no more.
GG's. I think he's underneath us. Nope. Not underneath us. Yeah, that was good. We're doing really well. Oh, I see him. Oh, he ran back to the spawn. Oh, wow. Oh, I committed to the wrong person. Oh, there's only two left. Nice. GG's.
Boost online.
One guy left. That was a good game. That was a good competition. Those were the people that we played against last game, or played with last game. Nice. GG's. But that guy that was running the mortars for you, that guy can eat a bag of dicks. Just saying. I'm glad we won, but it was a close game because those mortars were a son of a bitch. Not gonna lie. Like dodging skills while trying to like figure out. Ugh. I hate that part. As soon as I hear enemy artillery turret. Or whatever. Ugh. Hate it. Come on. Show the podium. I don't think I'm on top this one, though. We'll give whoever their flowers. Let's see what happened. Good old mortars. The mortars didn't work for you this time, did it there, bud? Hey, don't call me pal. Or don't call me bud, pal. Hey, don't call me pal, friend. Hey, don't call me friend. Oh, it's the guy with the it's the guy with the outfit. Oh, give Jeff his flowers. Hey, GG's. That was a good game. Good game. All right. We went 5-3-2, 36 million damage. That is more than any two of their teammates combined. Wow. And Jeff did 37 million. Dude, we went ham-a-lamb. Yo, our teammates went 2-8. Oof. All right. Well, we got the win, though. So, GG's. If you haven't already, hit that thumbs up. Support the channel by subscribing. I am Kamikaze Von Doom. Take care of yourself and enjoy the rest of your day. Peace out. Play. And I'll do my... One of my favorite missions, knowing that it's shorter, because some of these missions, man, ugh, they take like 30 minutes to complete. It is no bueno. So let's go with, we could go with cool skills. Fog of War, Fragile Armor. Even though Fragile Armor's broken as fuck. Yeah, there we go. That'll give us 100% more XP on Heroic. Yeah, that'll work. Okay, so this is what we're going to be doing. Link Memorial, Heroic, Solo, Four Directives, Hi-Ho Silva, Hawaii! Now, if you haven't already, hit that thumbs up. Support the channel. Let's get it.
Remove the True Sun's forces.
Let's get it.
The True Sons will be a direct threat to the campus.
Oh, they have Rager. They get super tanky. They get that Venom. I forgot about that. Maybe I shouldn't have put that on. Now they're going to be super tanky. Which is fine. It's just going to make me look better, right? Because I have to do more damage. I mean, I guess that's cool. Maybe I'll have some, like, wicked, crazy number at the end.
They're moving south. There's a gate between you. It looks closed from here.
Agent, you'll need to find a way to open that gate.
Yeah, let me turn down Isaac. Ooh. Isaac's blaring out my head. There we go. Blaring out my headset. There we go. I was about to say, I couldn't even hear myself think as soon as they were yelling at me. It's like, dang, why are you yelling at me? I'm on your side, man. Ooh. I feel like I'm lagging a little bit. Uh-oh. Yeah, let me see. Uh-oh, fragile armor. Got him. Ooh. Yo, if you're on Xbox today, are you experiencing some lag? I am. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's because their Rager is building up while I'm shooting them. But it seems like some of my damage is just delayed. You know what I'm saying? Go. Yeah, we got him. Not bad. If you're just now joining, remember you can rewind back to the build breakdown at the beginning. But this is chill out. 200% crit hit damage, max crit chance, perfect spada, and flatline. Oh. Oh, hey, 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 whoa, hey, 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 whoa, what do you know, hey. Did he just say I'm gonna die? Bro, you don't even know me. Like, what are you doing? Oh, those elites hit hard as a mother. Trucker. Oh no, oh no, you don't. Here I come to wreck the day. Let me just heal up real quick. There we go. Oh, bro. Yo, give me that bag. There we go. I was about to say. Nice. Really hoping that we get some rogue agents.
All clear.
But I doubt it.
Compound is all clear.
No, that can't be all of them. Check the interior while I get Henry's people to maintain the perimeter.
Oh, there we go. I was about to say, it's not going to give me my armor back. So we'll do this heroic four directives, and then we'll jump over to PvP using the exact same build. That way, I show you, you can use this in anything. PvE or PvP, doesn't matter. Super fun to use. It's just featuring the chill out mask and what the chill out mask can bring to the table. And in this situation, it's bringing 36% created damage just from the mask alone. It's crazy! We have all this armor with technically one blue. Which is pretty funny. Ooh, that turret's gonna hurt. Yep. That turret hurt. Yeah, that's not fair. Oh, my fragile armor's broken. Oh, that sucks. I'll try my armor again here in a second, but I'm pretty sure my armor's broken now. Let me know in the comments how to fix this, man. I hate it so much. Fragile armor needs to be fixed, please. For the love of the division, fix fragile armor. I love the premise, but why does it not fix itself? All right, watch. All right, armor's back. Papa Medi. Nope. It's broken.
Stay alert.
It sucks so hard. I think some people say change builds, right? Let me see really quick, because I have a PvE setup. There we go. Just save the PvE setup. All right, so I just changed the build, changed it back, all right? All right. It did not fix it, and let's use an armor kit. Nope. Damn it, man. That sucks so hard. Yo, and that door was delayed. Oh my gosh, this is just a buggy mess. I'm sorry that my experience right now is this way. I do apologize. It's not normally this way, I swear to you. But the fragile armor being bugged out, yes, that is a ongoing occurrence. Very frequent, indeed. Now I have no armor kits because the shit's broken. Damn it, man. That sucks so hard. This is going to be the one spot that I would go down to. Yeah, because I have no armor kits. Can't heal up. Oh, there's an armor kit. Standby. Oh, but it didn't fix the fragile armor. Dude. It sucks.
Serious trauma detected.
That means I just freaking wasted another armor kit. Oh. I'm gonna die right here. I have no armor. Play for me. Oh my gosh. The fragile armor struggle is real, my friends. Oh my gosh. Oh, this is real happening. I'm doing this with no armor. Hey, they said cover base shooter. Right? Cover base. There we go. Nice. GG's. And we got through it. But now I have two on my armor. Dude, this sucks so bad. Because if I use another armor kit just to hope that it'll be fixed, it won't be. And then I'm going to waste another armor kit. Oh my gosh, my 1.whatever million armor just dramatically went down. Oh, that's gonna hurt. Whatever. We got this. We got this. I guess I'll just not use the med kit and just hope.
We can lock that tunnel door from their control center. That should keep them from being able to transport those mortars loaded with DC-62.
Meow. Meow. Oh, the lag. Oh my gosh. The trigger pull lag right there was horrible. That was really, 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 really bad. Oh, the hit marker right there was... Oh, them hitting me's lagging. Oh my gosh, this is just horrible. Now I'm at negative 3 for my armor. Oh my gosh. This might be it, chat. This might be it. Oh no, another wave. Oh no. What if fragile armor isn't bugged and this is just the way it is?
That would hurt.
Oh! Behind me. Yo, what? How many more of you mother... There we go. Alright. Dude, now I'm on negative 3. Let me try. Oh, man. This sucks. Oh, this sucks so hard.
That should keep them from getting more of those mortars.
The door's like a second behind. Oh my gosh, man. This is horrible. Horrible. But it's funny though. I'm enjoying it still. It's hilarious. Alright, here we go. Alright, here we go. That was delayed. That was delayed. Oh my gosh. What is going on right now? Oh my gosh. Now I'm on negative 4. Oh, dude. Oh, dude. That means I have no freaking armor. Negative 4 is the max. I can't pull over any further, man. Dude, I'm dead. I'm dead, dude. Yeah, I'm dead. I'm dead. All he has to do is sneeze on me. Oh my gosh. All he has to do is freaking sneeze on me, bro. And I'm dead. Yo, am I doing this without any freaking armor right now? Is that what's happening? Oh no, he just freaking armored up. Yeah, see, it's all immune. Bro. As soon as he hits me with that fire, I'm dead. There's no way. Oh, I got the box! I got it! Let's fuck! Let's go! Yo, if you just saw that! Oh, man! Yo, the struggle was real for you, boy. Oh my god, dude. This fragile armor BS. Oof. Took me for a loop. But we did it. We conquered it. Let's go. Let's go. I was just saying how this is one of the faster missions, but here we go. 14 minutes later.
Thank you.
GG's.
Today, we dealt a great blow to the True Sun's infrastructure.
GG's. I earned that shade level. Holy crap.
And eliminated a stronghold near the campus. You should be proud. You saved a lot of lives today.
Alright, let's see. See what we did here. 600 million damage. 78 killed. 13 minutes. I said 14. Not bad. Alright. Okay. Well, that was the PvE portion. I just did heroic 4 directive solo with this build. Now let's jump into some PvP. If you haven't hit the thumbs up yet, what are you waiting on? Are you not entertained? All right, let's go. PvP.